let's get into primitive makeup.
I'm in it.
I know
so
you're in it.
What do you want to talk about?
So you...
I'm in a couple things.
Do both permanent makeup and body tattooing.
I do.
You do both. What did you enter the industry doing? What did you do first?
So I got interested in permanent makeup.
First.
And I started off about 2 months first.
All right.
In microblading. And I had no idea what I was doing. And I figured out, well, let me go to a tattoo shop and learn.
Okay.
And I've always been an artist ever since I was little. And I even went to the beauty industry for a little while, did nails. I even did the nail art. Like, really good nail art.
Okay.
But anyways, long story short, really I'd like to say in the tattoo world, permanent makeup was my introduction.
Okay, so you got licensed, trained and licensed in permanent makeup first.
No, I actually went to a really not so good training first, and then I decided to go into a tattoo shop.
And
it's called a street shop.
So would you say that you kind of trained in permanent makeup and body tattooing simultaneously?
Absolutely. I will like to say I did, yeah.
Kind of both at the same time simultaneously. Mm-hmm. So I was a little bit different.
Yeah.
I entered as a permanent makeup artist.
Mm-hmm.
3.5 years later, got an apprenticeship in body tattooing and, you know, so yeah. So that's how I did that. But you kind of did it simultaneously. Man, that must have been hard though because...
It was hard.
Because I think it's the same... Right? Body tattooing and permanent makeup, it's kind of the same, but yet it's so different.
Huge difference.
So
but it's
you're
less
learning...
colorful. It's, you know, with body art, you've got more color, you've got more.
Yeah, way more color.
You know, more prep.
Yeah.
Permanent makeup, I love it.
Yeah.
I'm like, oh, come in with your face and that's it. And I know how to bob and weave what I've got to go do.
So what do you do more of these days? More permanent makeup or more body tattooing?
More permanent makeup just because of the demand of good healed results, and I've been able to produce that with continuing education through the years and messing up people's faces.
Do you have a preference? Do you prefer one over the other?
No, I don't. Well,
get convenience out of the
way.
Here's
the deal. If it wasn't for convenience.
Yeah, because conveniently.
I love body art. That's like a passion of mine.
Okay.
I love body art because I just get to create, and you know, with permanent makeup, there's very little room for error.
Yeah.
And you could accidentally, you could do something and on the spot and be like, oh, this would be great. And you could just more artistic, and it works my brain a lot better.
I get
more excited.
Yeah. And I think, don't you think with, this was my experience going from, you know, because in the course of a day, I could have a couple permanent makeup procedures, a couple body tattoo procedures, and I found the clientele's different. Going from a permanent makeup client and then transitioning into a body tattoo client, you know, that was easy. But transitioning from a body tattoo, if you started your day with a body tattoo, going from a body tattoo client where
ease up a
the
bit.
Language can get a little colorful, right?
Yeah.
You know, and all that. And then having to transition into a permanent makeup client was definitely harder.
Absolutely. And it just depends on how you as an artist collect those clients and what you get.
Yeah.
And stuff like that. Because I also did body piercing for a while too.
Yeah. You know what I ended up having to do was either like do my permanent makeup during the day because I was in permanent makeup mode and schedule like body work at the end of the day, or I would delegate like a couple of days for just body tattooing and then 3 or 4 days for just my permanent makeup, because transitioning back and forth was hard on me. I felt it was just hard on me.
Yeah.
Right?
It just depends. Like when I'm doing body art and I mean, I'm going in a lot differently than I'm going in for permanent makeup, softer. It just depends.
See if you agree with me. I felt the permanent makeup client was more emotionally consuming of us.
Oh, yeah.
But the body tattoo client was more, less emotional consuming, but more time consuming, right?
Absolutely.
Eyebrows, you know, in, numbing, design, do it out the door, hour and a half. A body tattoo comes in. Who the hell knows how long, right? They got to approve the drawing. You try to get that done prior, but then, you know, you don't know until they come in and you put the stencil on them. Do you like where it's located? Do they want it smaller? Do they want it this? Run into the copy machine, making it smaller, making it bigger, blah, 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 right?
Oh, yeah. It's a whole bigger, it takes more energy to do that.
Yeah.
A lot more energy.
Yeah. But did you find they were emotionally less draining on you?
Oh, way less.
Two clients?
Way less.
Yeah.
Yeah. And, you know, I hurt people for a living physically, like I tattoo people. So it's a lot better with body art. They tend to suck it up.
Yeah. Tend to suck it up.
Anyways. Yeah.
All right. Okay.